Over the weekend, I discovered an amazing way to use ChatGPT deep research to improve your English. This is, I think, pretty mind-blowing. We'll compare with some other deep research AI tools as well, but our main one will be ChatGPT deep research with the reasoning model 01. What are we going to do? We are going to build a custom digest. A digest has different sources that we want to learn from, different kinds of things. Let's call this a weekly digest. So maybe every week, to work on my English skills, I want to read some articles that I'm interested in. Maybe I want to work on some grammar, but I don't just want random grammar from ChatGPT. I want real grammar questions that people, other English learners like me, really ask, really think about, are really working on. Maybe I want a TED Talk, an interesting TED Talk. And some other things, some idioms I can learn. Anyway, I have some things that I want to learn, and I want these things to be real things, not just things that ChatGPT makes up out of thin air. Real sources with real links. And I want it all together in a digest that I can look at the beginning of every week to work on throughout the week. This is so cool. So let's do this. Let's first go through the prompt here because the prompt has quite a few pieces. I will put this prompt in the description of this video, but it's very important that you customize it according to your needs and interests. The whole point of this is that it is a custom weekly learning digest. Very important. So I want you to create a personalized weekly learning digest based on my interests and learning goals. Results should be given in simple and clear English with clear formatting. Include the following. Now, this is what I want. I want five different things. I want five things. Find an interesting and useful grammar question and its answer from the subreddit Reddit English Learning. So that's where a lot of people ask questions. Choose something that is clearly explained and relevant for intermediate to advanced learners. Now, if you're at a different level, change the prompt. If you want it from a different source, this is a great source, change the prompt. Basically, what I'm asking for is deep research to go off and find that interesting question with the real answer. This is all real stuff that I'm getting. I don't have to go off and find it. I'm doing this prompt once a week, and every time, the results are going to be different. That's the cool thing about this. Number two, find a TED Talk on TED.com on a topic related to technology or business. Change that according to your interests, right? Give me this information, the speaker, the link to the talk. Very important to get the link so that I can just click on it and watch the video. And a bullet point summary of the main ideas. Three, search the web for two articles in English related to recent discoveries in science, archaeology, and AI. Provide the title, a link, and a concise bullet point summary. So similar to the TED Talk, you can ask for two articles, maybe three articles, whatever. Next, I want three idioms. Include three idioms from live search from idioms.thefreedictionary.com. Provide the link to each idiom from thefreedictionary.com. So what is live search? Let me go to the free dictionary here. On the idioms page, and this is a fantastic page, you could ask for the idiom of the day. Give me the idiom of the day and the linked YouTube video under the idiom of the day. You can ask for that. These are live searches, things that people are really searching. Green stuff, push through phrases, right? Freewheeling. The point here is that you have some places where you like to get information from Reddit, from this website, from that website, from TED, from YouTube. And you know what the pages are, but you don't want to do the work of finding, finding, finding. And so you're getting the digest put together for you from those places you rely on without having to do that work. And then finally, provide three interesting discussion topics I can use to practice conversation skills with ChatGPT. Understand, again, what's happening here, the structure, change this, but then you just paste it into deep research. We're going to try this not just with ChatGPT, but with different deep research tools. So ChatGPT deep research with 01, search, begin. Gemini 2.0 Flash with deep research, same exact prompt. Begin. We might get some follow-up questions for each of these. We'll answer those. Perplexity, which is kind of meh on deep research, in my opinion. Let's do that. And then Grok, deep research. And there's another thing with Grok called deeper research that I was playing with, and it didn't work so well. By the way, if you are working on your English skills, feel free to check out the 90-day program. This 90-day program is over 50 hours of lessons. There is evaluations and practice assignments throughout, checked by AI. You have conversations with AI to practice your English, and it's all automated. Everything comes into your email. You do the assignments, and it's really cost-effective because of that. So you can get the benefits of real-time conversation and practicing your English skills, learning grammar, learning the key skills and habits, very important habits that you need to become fluent in English. So check out the program. I spent a lot of time building this program and I'm very proud of it. And I think it's a great way, very cost-effective way to improve your English skills. You also get a certificate on completion. Anyway, check that out. Links in the description. Okay, with Google, there are no follow-up questions, but you have to check the plan. And you can edit the plan, which is pretty cool, and then start research. That works. It looks like Perplexity is done. I don't have very high expectations of Perplexity. So the question is from Reddit English Learning, since these two sentences are not. So there are a few different questions here about present continuous and conditionals. Okay, so that's the question. In conditionals, we can use will and would. And here's the answer. Okay, so that looks pretty good. TED Talk on technology. How do you keep up to date with everything technology has to offer? Let's see. Speaker Mike Saunders. So here's the link to TED. Let's try this. All right, so there's a TED Talk. And the cool thing about TED Talks is they have usually a good transcript, and you can watch the transcript play. That's usually pretty cool. Okay, good. So far, so good on Perplexity, and this is free. Recent discoveries in archaeology, tomb of Thutmose II found. Really? Okay. February 19th. That's cool. Okay, so that's an article on Wikipedia, ancient evidence of forced labor in Egyptian mines. This is all about Egyptian stuff. This is also from Wikipedia. Okay, maybe too much from Wikipedia. Okay, also from Wikipedia. Okay, English grammar quiz for intermediate learners. Here are some example questions to test your skills. I didn't ask for a quiz, did I? Everyday conversation patterns, huh? Okay, this is going off the rails. Discussion topics, okay, so there are my discussion topics. So with Perplexity, I didn't get everything that I asked for. I did not get everything I asked for. It kind of got lost. There are some sources, but my digest is not quite what I was looking for. All of the articles were from one source, so that's a little bit disappointing. All right, let's check Grok. Grammar practice, interesting grammar question for intermediate to advanced learners. Why is would be feeling used instead of have been feeling? That's a good question. Where is the link? So that is a good question. I like the question, but where's the link to the source? Okay, the TED Talk, okay. What is an AI anyway? All right, so that is a real link. And there's a summary that looks decent. Recent discoveries in science, archaeology, and AI. So there's from the Berkeley Lab, an article about DESI results, whatever that is. And let's see, we have another one. Oh, different sources, that's good. One from National Geographic. LIDAR reveals a medieval city along the Silk Road. And then this one, how squirrels land on branches could help design better robots. That's actually a really interesting one. I'm going to have to read that one later. Idioms for everyday English. Break a leg. Are these actually live searches? Cost an arm and a leg, hit the nail on the head. Those are idioms, but is it from the free dictionary? Oh, it is. It is. What are the odds that someone was live searching all of these really common idioms? I'm a little suspicious that it didn't actually take it from the live searches, but those are very good. And then my discussion topics. Here are three topics to discuss with ChatGPT. Should schools ban smartphones? Is it ethical to use AI to create art or music? And what are the pros and cons of working from home? Those are really interesting discussion topics. So I have here, I think, a pretty solid weekly digest, articles from different sources, a TED Talk, the Reddit English Learning grammar question doesn't have a link, but hey, it does have the question, and I just have to trust it's real. But it would be nice to have that. But I think deep research from Grok did a better job than Perplexity for sure. Wow. And here's the one from Google Deep Research. I like the table. This looks good. And do we have links? So the links are here. The links are here. There's the article link. There's that article link. And is this to the free dictionary? No, it is not. No, it is not. I said cite the free dictionary. It has not cited the free dictionary. Uh-oh. So not following instructions there. The results were better in Grok, actually. And I don't know what the heck this is. Oh, is this actually a question? Okay, maybe this is okay. Okay, effect versus effect. Am I the only one who will never understand? All right, I take it back. Google did do a good job at linking the source to the Reddit question. What I don't really like is the wall of words. And I don't really like that it didn't cite the free dictionary. And see, no free dictionary. And sometimes we get this big chunk of text. I'm not a fan of that. But okay, not too bad. I think Grok is better. Now the moment of truth. Back to ChatGPT. A grammar Q&A. It's given us a bullet point list. A grammar Q&A from Reddit English Learning. A relevant TED Talk. Two articles on recent developments in science, archaeology, or AI. Three idioms with links and multiple example sentences. Okay, let's see. Oh, okay. With a little call out formatting, original question from Reddit. What's the difference between these words? Example, I used to play soccer with my father. I would play soccer with my father. Okay. And let's see, used to and would. Right. There it is. That's pretty good. Right. There it is. There's the question. All right. Good. So the first one is good with a good answer, it looks like. Nice bullet points, no wall of words. And the formatting. I love how ChatGPT does the formatting for these reports. If you ask for clear formatting, you get things like callouts like this, so it's easy to read. Oh, this is the question, and here's the answer, and it has citations and it's bullet points. Talk of the week. Okay, what is an AI anyway? Okay, same talk. That makes me worried that what if next week it's the same talk again? So I'll have to try that out next week and see. Archaeology.org, researchers reconstruct Western Europe's oldest human face. Might have to read more about that later. That's pretty interesting. Wow, the oldest human face. I have a bullet point list there. Robot gains new abilities with help from plants and fungi. Fungi? Fungi? What do you say? Idioms and phrases. Break the ice. Hit the nail on the head. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. View on the free dictionary. Where's my link? I want a view on the free dictionary, but I didn't get a link. And also, I don't think these were live searches. I think these are just general idioms. I mean, they're useful, but those definitely weren't being searched live. And then conversation topics. How do you think modern technology has changed? What scientific discovery or invention do you find most interesting? And history, if you could discover a lost historical treasure or ancient site. Okay, those are good questions. So with ChatGPT, very good formatting, good sources, well put together. It's all good, except for I wanted it to link to the free dictionary and it did not. And I wanted it to find it from live searches and it did not. So that's a bit of a fail. And so I guess none of these have been totally perfect. I think the formatting on this one is really good. I'm kind of a stickler for formatting because it makes it readable. It makes it feel like a real digest, right? So I could take this and I could use this week to learn a lot, right? And if you just use that same prompt every week, maybe tweaking it a bit each week, you're going to get some great resources that you can use without having to go out and find it all yourself. A nice package, a packet of helpful information that you're actually interested in learning, discovering, exploring, learning English from, practicing with. Again, maybe not 100% perfect yet, but getting very close. And I've, in my testing, honestly, have had perfect results from a couple of these. So maybe it's hit or miss, but it has worked in the past. And when it does, you can just click on that and explore that idiom on the page. Grok did a really good job with that. Google did a pretty good job with that. The great thing about all of these doing deep research is that it's not always free, but at least one of them will be free at some point, right? At least Perplexity is free, as far as I know. And Grok and Google and ChatGPT has some limitations. So you have a lot of tools at your fingertips. You can figure out which one you like best. You can tweak the prompt so that you get a really tight, clean digest. So you have no excuses to not learn something every single week. You can create a checklist, basically, maybe a Notion. Did I learn, explore, go through everything from my digest this week? Do that at the end of the week. Check, 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 check. I did everything. And then, hey, this week was a success. Maybe have a big check mark on this week. And then do the same thing next week and the next week. Well, if you've done it 3 weeks in a row, then not doing it the fourth week, that would be a shame. I would be letting myself down. I wouldn't want to do that to myself. So I have to do it this week. Having streaks going weeks in a row is a very powerful thing. Putting all of this together into a system that isn't a pain to do. You don't have to go out and find all of this stuff. It kind of comes to you with the right prompts. You get everything that you need to do the stuff you need to do without all of the annoying, time-consuming stuff going on Google and searching and scrolling and scrolling and searching, right? Try the prompt out for yourself. Let me know how it goes. If you haven't done so already, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Get a free course in the links in the description. You can also get a free English evaluation in the links in the description to test your spoken English and check out the 90-day program. This is over 50 hours of lessons, assignments checked by AI, live interactive practice, spoken English practice to improve your English fluency. The assignments show up in your email with a link to get feedback from AI. So it holds you accountable. It pushes you. You unlock content over time. And if you complete the entire 90-day program, you get a one-year membership at no additional cost. But you have to complete the program. So I think it's a great way to improve your English fluency and change your habits. Smash through that barrier that's holding you back. Check that out in the links in the description. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.